We want to find the standard equation of the ellipse that has a center of 3, negative 1, a focus of 3, 2, and a vertex of 3, 5. Notice there are two forms of the standard equation of an ellipse based upon whether we have a vertical major axis or a horizontal major axis. In both cases, a is greater than b, and therefore a squared is going to be the larger denominator. So if the larger denominator, or a squared, is under the y part of the equation, we'll have a vertical major axis as pictured here. Remember, the major axis is the longer axis. And if a squared, or the larger denominator, is under the x part of the equation, we would have a horizontal major axis. In either case, in order to find the equation of an ellipse in this form, we need to find h and k, which are the coordinates of the center of the ellipse, which would be this point here. And then we need to find a and b so that we can find a squared and b squared, where a is the distance from the center to the two endpoints of the major axis, and b is the distance from the center to the two endpoints of the minor axis. So I think the best place to start is to plot the given information on the coordinate plane and then analyze the information. The center of the ellipse has coordinates 3, negative 1, which would be here. And if we're given the center, we know that h must be equal to 3 and k must be equal to negative 1. Next, we're told a focus has coordinates 3, 2. So 3, 2 would be here. But we should recognize that if one focus is 3 units above the center, then there must be another focus 3 units below the center, which would be this point here. And then finally, we're given a vertex has coordinates 3, 5. The vertices of the ellipse are the two endpoints of the major axis. So the point 3, 5 would be here. And again, notice how this point is 6 units above the center, and therefore the other endpoint of the major axis, or the other vertex, must be 6 units below the center, which would be here. So because the major axis contains both the vertices and the foci, we now know that we have a vertical major axis, which means our equation is going to take this form here, where a squared, or the larger denominator, will be under the y part of the equation. And also, because we have the vertices and the foci of the ellipse, we can also determine the value of a and the value of c. A is a distance from the center to the vertices of the ellipse. Looking at our points, since this distance here is equal to 6 units, we know a is equal to 6. And then the distance from the center to the foci is equal to c units. Notice this distance here is equal to 3 units, so we know c is equal to 3. But notice how we need b squared in order to write our equation, which would be the distance from the center to the two endpoints of the minor axis. And we could find b squared using the equation a squared equals b squared plus c squared, which is always true for an ellipse. And since we're trying to find b squared, if we were to solve this for b squared, we would subtract c squared on both sides. We would have b squared equals a squared minus c squared. And since we have a and c, we can find a squared and c squared. B squared is going to be equal to a squared, which would be 6 squared, or 36, minus c squared. And since c is 3 and 3 squared is 9, we have minus 9. So we have b squared is equal to, this would be 27. And this is all the information we need in order to find our equation. Our equation is going to be x minus h, or in this case, x minus 3 squared, divided by b squared, which we just found to be 27, plus the quantity y minus k squared, where k is negative 1, so y minus negative 1 would become y plus 1 squared, divided by a squared. Well, we know a is equal to 6, therefore a squared would be equal to 36. And this is equal to positive 1. So this would be the equation of our ellipse based upon the given information. But let's finish by graphing this specific ellipse. Notice how to graph the ellipse, we also need the endpoints of the minor axis. And those endpoints are B units to the left and right of the center, since we have a vertical major axis. Well, we know B squared is equal to 27. And we only want the positive value of B, so we'll take the principal square root of both sides of the equation. That would give us B equals the square root of 27. We can write 27 as 9 times 3. And since the square root of 9 is equal to 3, B is equal to 3 square root 3. But because we're going to use this to plot the endpoints of the minor axis, let's get a decimal approximation. This comes out to approximately 5.196. Which means the two endpoints of the minor axis will be approximately 5.196 units to the right and left of the center. So if the x value here is 3, we'll go out a little bit past 8, maybe to here, and we'll go to the left a little bit past negative 2. So this would be the minor axis of the ellipse. So notice how the length of the major axis would be 2 times a, or in this case 2 times 6 or 12 units long, and the length of the minor axis would be 2 times b, or approximately 2 times 5.196, which would be almost 10.4. And because these two lengths are not that different, notice how the ellipse is very circular. It would look something like this. Okay, I hope you found this example helpful.